Right, we are back. We're going to be doing an experiment today. This is a wireless charging module, and I'm going to try and incorporate that into this coaster mold. Now, a disclaimer, if you try this, do not go plugging this in straight away with bare hands, because you will get a shock. This is a bare module for builders of electronic equipment to use. So you can basically build this into a charging station, but we're going to make that with resin. So what I've done to begin with is I've packed the USB connection just with some white tack or putty, whatever you've got. Just push it right down. It's going to be a struggle to get it out afterwards, but I think it'll be worth it. And you can see some bare terminals at the back there. So what I'm going to do quickly just to prep that, it's just I'm going to use some UV resin. You could probably just pack the back again with some putty, whatever you've got. But I'm just going to hopefully just prevent any big leakage of resin through to the port. But I think I've packed it enough anyway to not need to worry so much. So I'm just going to go with a basic alcohol ink drop in my coaster, because it is an experiment, and if it works I will work on it a bit more in the future. So first of all, we need our layer, because we don't want to be able to see this. It's quite ugly. And then we're going to need to we'll do our first layer, let that cure, then we need to position this and sadly cut a small hole. We might be able to get away with not cutting a hole, but we'll see when we get to that stage. Right, so for the resin, we're going to be using the collab resin. For the alcohol inks, again, we've got the Let's Resin 26 ink set. Let's get mixing. Right, so I have really gone shallow in this because we need to allow room for our charger port and the module. So I'm just going to, I did want to use my pinata sinker for this, just to get a more blobby effect, but I can't find it. It's just typical. So I'm just going to randomly drop colours from the alcohol ink set. I'm just hoping that we can get these inks to be as opaque as possible so that we can't see the charging port. It doesn't matter too much if we can, because it is an experiment and it's something we can work on. So what I might do this time round is layer some inks. What I mean by layer is add our colours, then add a white, then add a colour on top, just to ensure that we don't have any negative space or transparency. And I'm just hoping these inks don't draw inwards. Right, let's see how that settles down in a few moments. Oh, in case you're new to my channel, what I've just added is the white sea deeper. I just put mine inside this needle tip bottle. Yeah, so I'm going to go in with another layer of my inks just on top, and that should hopefully do it. Again, massive shout out to my channel members. Thank you for signing up and supporting the channel. Thank you to anyone who's bought a coffee or a super thanks. Massive support to my channel. And if you haven't hit that sub button yet, go ahead and do that for me. It all helps. I do love an experiment. Knowing my luck, I'll go to switch it on afterwards and there'll be no power. Right, Right, and hopefully we might get some blobbing as well, as I want some blobbing in this just to give it a different effect than what we normally get. So now what we're going to do is wait for our stir, and then we'll be back. See you in a bit. We're almost at stirring stage. You can see my inks have pulled in a bit. I'm not going to add any more now. It's a bit too late. But before we start with the stirring, I'll just give you a bit more info on this. So this is by a company called Buwina on Amazon. I'll pop the link in the description. It does have an automatic temperature cutout. So if it reaches a temperature that's too hot for the circuitry to run, it will cut out for 1 minute, cool down, and then start again. You do need a wireless phone, a compatible phone for a wireless charger. There are a lot of phones at the moment which do. I've got a Samsung, you've got iPhones that do also allow you to use wireless charging. But again, guys, this is an experiment. If it works, I will test it and see how the resin reacts with this in it over time, and I'll give you an update. But with the temperature cutout, the safety stuff that's already built into this, I really can't see there being an issue. A lot of the pieces of the wireless chargers do sit in houses of plastic, and this is essentially what we're doing. So another reason why we need that shallow pour is that this module does need a distance. The recommended distance is 2 to 4 millimeters from the coil to the back of the phone. So if you've got a phone case, you might need to take that off. But the maximum distance is up to 8 millimeters, but that will depend on the thickness of what you're basically surrounding the module with. It does also have some blue LED indicators on the bottom of this circuit board. So hopefully that will glow up the bottom of the coaster once we've got it all plugged in at the end, if it works. Right, are we ready for stirring? Not quite. Right, we're ready to stir. Another really important thing with this is that people don't use this as a drinks coaster, because if you've got this plugged in, the last thing you want is someone spilling their drink and causing a serious accident. Again, this is why I'm calling this an experiment. But if it works, it's going to be a pretty cool. What you could do once you've demoulded it is, if you've got a Cricut Joy or any type of vinyl cutting machine, could have done it before really and submerged it, but just put a lightning symbol across it, but just make sure that it's not used for drinks. So we now need to just wait for that layer to cure. Right, so now that first layer is cured, we need to place our circuit board and just work out roughly. You want it in the center as best as possible. Doesn't matter if they overlap slightly, but we need that charging port really tucked up against the edge of the mould. Right, so I've got mine roughly where I need it to be, and I've really tucked that USB connection up against the mould. And what we're going to do is just secure that in place with some UV resin. So I'm just going to go around the whole, not the whole, but just dab it around, because I'm worried that this could float. Now you could do this with another layer of two part, but I'm gonna kind of rush this, and you won't see it anyway because it'll be underneath, which is good. So I've just gone around the coil itself and just adhered that down with UV, and just on the corners of the chips. And I just needed to remember to be careful that the UV doesn't go underneath the circuit board, because that won't cure properly. And if it makes connections with the circuit board underneath, then there's a potential risk of a hazard. And then I've just gone around this port on the silicone just to ensure that that's sealed nice and tight. So when it comes to demolding, we'll have less effort hopefully getting to that port. So now for the final layer. Right, so we just pour on our final layer and make sure our mould is really flat and level. And I want enough just to cover that charging, that USB port, sorry. Any bubbles I can come back to and pop later to see how that settles down. So that's it. It's now just a waiting game and keeping our fingers crossed. See you soon. Right, the moment of truth. You see a random little island of bubbles there that must have been trapped underneath the coil. I really hope this has worked. That's a good sign. I can still access the putty. Look at that. You can just see that area up there, but as a prototype, you can't see, you can't really see anything through that. So now I just need to get my little pin and just take my time to get all of this putty out and then get it cleaned up. I won't bore you with that part. So it only took about 5 or so minutes, and it was quite satisfying, really, to be honest with you. So I'm going to test this now, and I'm wondering whether my portable power bank would be enough, just to see if we get some lights. Right, so something happened. Let's turn off the power bank. Oh, you can't, it turns off itself. I'd rather do this with the power bank than go plugging it into the mains. There you go. So we've got an indicator, which is a really good sign. Now, there you go. It is now charging my phone wirelessly. And you can see that battery symbol just up in the top right there. You can't really see the glow from the underneath, but it is lighting up. It's daytime, you can't really see it. It worked. Unbelievable. I think the circuit board in there only cost me about £4, I think. So it's something to work with. It's a really cool idea. And you could do this with flower blooms. If you did that initial layer with a flower bloom, and that you could do lots. Again, guys, give this one a share, because it is an experiment. It's an interesting experiment. Yeah, give the video a thumbs up, drop me a comment. And if you haven't hit that sub button, do it. Right, I'll see you for the next one. Bye for now.